I'm like the only food truck for Garifuna foods that you can find.
Anywhere you see this, you want to see it on a highway, on a freeway, or going around LA. Saraba, which means wake up. I'm trying to wake up your taste buds.
Winston, his job is almost like to introduce the world to our culture via our food. When you look at our lineage and our history, we've always been fighting to preserve our culture. And as a Garifuna person, that's the number one thing that you're ingrained with as soon as you're born.
My name is Winston Miranda. We're at my location at 1425 South La Brea. And this is where the food truck is, Saraba Garifuna Cuisine. Serving authentic Caribbean, Belizean, and Garifuna food. The food truck been for 8 years, going around LA. On mines, I have the jerk chicken, I got oxtail, I got curry chicken, I got stew chicken, I got fried fish, I got grilled fish. Garifuna people are indigenous people. That came from Africa.
Garifuna people are the direct descendants of Africans and Arawaks. We shipwrecked in front of St. Vincent when we were brought from Africa as slaves.
That's where Garifuna, Carib, Garifuna started. They founded their own way of communication. They went through what they had to go through in St. Vincent while they had to flee, and so they all end up on the Mosquito Coast.
From Africa to St. Vincent, from St. Vincent to Honduras, from Honduras to Belize.
We have a variety of food. My favorite, which is the hudut, which is the white gravy with fish.
The hudut is like special order, so you'll call me and tell me, okay, I want to play the hudut, and then I'll make it with the fried plantain, with the coconut sauce. It's very flavorful.
It's really, really good. The fish is fried well, seasoned well. I love my plantain really sweet, so it's really, really good. It just accentuates and accents everything perfectly.
Wherever the Garifuna people migrated at, they'll take a little bit of everything. It's a melting pot. So you bite off of every other ethnicity. Oh, you got it from the Mestizos, the Mayans, the East Indians then.
We're a tobacco store and an instant oil store, but we started doing food in the parking lot, and my buddy Winston came down with Saraba and started up the jerk chicken and everything that we do here. The Garifuna culture, I never knew anything about. You know, it was just something that he's been teaching me about, you know, slowly but surely. Monday nights, we have a drum circle that's coming in now, this, that, and whatever, and he's a part of that also. So the whole vibe and the culture of the smoke shop itself has changed.
Oh, I'd like to introduce my assistant Alicia. Oh, my next door neighbor.
Like, hey, neighbor.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, that smells good over there, neighbor.
In LA, I say we got roughly between about 50,000 and up, Garifuna people that live out here. We got a lot living in New York, Miami, but we pretty spread in Houston. Anything that you see a little ocean around there, you'll find a lot of Garifuna people around.
This is your fish plate, love, and here's your oxtails, extra plantains, and jerk chicken.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, I was born in Stan Creek, which is the southern part of Belize. Everybody used to look out for each other. I learned from my great-grandmother. She was the one who used to be in the kitchen cooking. May she rest in peace. She's the one that taught me a lot of stuff about my culture. She taught me how to make everything from scratch.
This is where the hard labor comes in at. We youngsters, we struggle, but my great-grandma would take like 10 hits, and the planting would be done.
So you guys got two halves, two jerk oxtail plates?
Yeah.
25, so 50 in total? 25. Give us like 5-10 minutes because you're getting fresh cabbage. All right.
I play soccer. It was a professional game. I played with the under 19 team. We used to travel a lot, you know, go to different countries and played. And that's when I started exploring the world. When you start getting old, then that bone start hurting you, you know what I'm saying? You don't want to run around and do all that stuff. So, hey, I said, oh, let me start let me just concentrate more on my cooking. And my uncle was the one that usually said, hey, man, you have a gift, utilize it. After I graduated from school, I came out here. My mom and dad was here in California. So that's where, like, my home base. And then I went to culinary school at the Art Institute of Seattle. At night, after 2 o'clock, from 2 to like 5:30, I'd be outside in the after hour club selling food. I did it for at least 5 years straight. I did it because there was a shortage Garifuna food out here. Most people make it out their house. I said, you know what? Might as well I just go ahead and do it. I think in the whole country, I think we'll have like two Garifuna restaurants. Now I'm one of them that I know about. And then that's where the word starts spreading around. Oh, this guy told me, come on down here to come get it. I got people that drive all the way from San Francisco just to come try the food. From New York when they hear about it, because New York don't even have a Garifuna restaurant.
Okay, we're gonna start smoking the jerk chicken. It's seasoned with allspice, habanero pepper, ginger, a little bit of molasses, with cilantro, and coriander. It takes something a whole day for a good marination. And then to cook, about an hour with the breast and wings and all that, say about an hour and a half. It's spicy for your palate, but not too hot, like how the Jamaican make it real hot. I give you your sauce and everything so you can burn yourself up. I don't want to burn it up for you. So I'm gonna cover it down so you can smoke a little bit.
Fine dining is good, you know what I'm saying? You can design the food the way you want, but most of the fine dining don't even have that flavor. The street food is the one that got all the flavor there. Grilling, frying, doing everything in the kitchen. That's my passion. Everybody was came to this place to start to do something different. Mine's is cooking. That's what I love. First thing in the morning, I get up, 5 o'clock, sometimes 4 o'clock, I do my prayer. I go shopping in the morning time. I prefer to go early.
Dame una media caja de los plátanos. Half ripe, half
Half yellow.
Yeah.
This one?
Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, this one right here. Today I got most of the product for the hudut. It's a staple of the Garifuna food. That's what we feast on most of the time. So like the plantains, like the staple of the Garifuna culture.
And after that, I come to the food truck, I do all my preparation, and then I start my day.
Put the rest of the jerk, or you can put it in this pan right here, the rest of the jerk in here, and then we're gonna transfer it over, okay? It should be done by now. We got the drummers, the Garifuna drummers coming.
That's our culture. We're known from playing the drums a lot.
This drum, we use it for spiritual reasons. My culture is special. It's something I am proud of. When you hear the drum, at this moment, it sounds like a horse is running. Everything we do drum-wise is connected to Mother Nature.
For the future generation, it's important because we want that our children and our children's children be able to know and identify themselves as Garinugu. We want our children to be proud of who they are.
Belize a lot. A lot of us that who came from Belize haven't been back home in a long, long time. I prefer like to teach the kids and like my daughter. I'm trying to teach her the culture, teach her the food. Whenever she try to get older and travel or go to Belize, she'll know exactly the typical Garifuna food look like. She was like, okay, my dad taught me this. And if she go to Honduras and all that, she will know about the plantains, she will know about the coconuts, she will know about everything. She'll be a multicultural American. I really want them to uphold that culture, not to forget where you come from. Like, my daughter is my main goal, like, I'm pushing. I want her to be better than me. I guarantee my daughter gonna take it over. She'll be successful. I can feel it in her.